Now, ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Montreal, Canada, weighing 282 pounds, here is Butcher Paul Vachon. And his opponent, weighing 250 pounds, from the Fiji Isles, here is Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Well, it's grounded its feet. Tremendously popular, Superfly Jimmy Snuka.
One of the most incredible athletes in professional wrestling today, Mr. Snuka. Preparing for his matchup with the Big Butcher at 282 pounds. Vachon against Snuka is going to be quite a match indeed.
Vachon, ring veteran.
There's a look at the poster of the Superfly. Boy, he can fly like no one. All right, now we're ready for one-on-one competition.
It's action-packed. It is crammed with great photos. It is crammed with super stories on your favorite wrestlers from all over the world. It's the official World Wrestling Federation magazine. It is a great publication. We certainly invite you to become a subscriber. 8 action-packed issues for only $14.47. Send check or money order for that amount to WWF Magazine, Post Office Box 1538, Greenwich, Connecticut, 06836.
Look at the Butcher raking the back of Superfly Snuka. And this capacity crowd is no doubt upset over the latest turn of events. Vachon is really taking it to Snuka.
Well, Paul the Butcher Vachon.
And 282 pounds of him is really having an effect on the Superfly.
Irish whip from Vachon.
Vachon hesitating, but nonetheless moving in now and continuing his attack on the phenomenal Superfly Snuka. Snuka backing off. Again, Vachon in the corner with a blatant chokehold, and the referee perhaps.
Oh, look at this. He is fighting. He's fighting the Superfly.
Referee certainly at any moment now could disqualify Mr. Vachon.
Well, I hope Vachon realizes fully what he is dishing out. He may ultimately have to take in return from the popular Superfly.
Things looking quite bleak, however, at the moment for Superfly Snuka. Vachon just has been all over him. A blatant chokehold. The forearm, the left forearm of Vachon right up against the throat of Snuka. Snuka spinning into it now, getting a little bit of room. Snuka with an elbow. Vachon in a corner. Snuka now countering quite a bit. Brings him out to the middle of the ring. Snuka with a headbutt.
Oh! Look at that!
Superfly outside. Snuka going up to the top rope.
Listen to these
Superfly
fans.
Superfly Snuka with another headbutt.
Oh, the Superfly airborne on to victory over Butcher Vachon. Oh, what action.
We'll get the official time.
Here is the time, 2 minutes and 55 seconds. It is the winner, Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
What an impressive comeback. Big offensive mounted in the early going of the bout by Butcher Vachon. And Snuka took some tremendously harsh treatment.
Indeed he did. Nonetheless, it's super.
Well, Gorilla Monsoon, the crowd still buzzing after the decision a few moments ago. And the draw, time expiring on Eddie Gilbert, Rene Goulet. But before he can breathe, we're getting ready for match number 2 of the World Wrestling Federation. We've got a great lineup. And here are some familiar faces that you can see entering the ring at this time.
Two big super heavyweights.
You bet.
Swede, Hanson, and the Butcher. Let's go up to our ring announcer.
This contest, ladies and gentlemen, in this corner, 285 pounds. He is in the blue trunks from Montreal, Canada, Paul Vachon. And in this corner, wrestling fans, black trunks, 300 pounds from Slaughter Creek, North Carolina, Swede, Hanson, Hanson. Your referee for this contest, Dusty Feldbomber, one fall to a 20-minute time limit.
All right, the Swede sporting some chin scratch, some whiskers there.
Well, it must be a centennial coming up or something, Dick, or he lost a bet or whatever.
Down there in Slaughter Creek, that could be the truth. Anyway, the butcher, Paul the Butcher, Vachon, and we've seen him many, many times, and from a very distinguished, again, wrestling family from Montreal.
Thank God, I'm sure that they've reinforced this ring tonight, Dick. Not only for these two characters, but you got Andre coming up in that eight-man tag with the three Samoans in there. That's the real test for any ring.
For sure.
Andre gets stomping around in there with those 320, 30-pound Samoans. Anything could happen.
Probably will. And we make contact. Oh! Vachon shoved into the ring corner. Mighty effort there by Swede Hanson. I started to say earlier, some distinguished people in the press box, a gang of guys from Channel 6 here in Philadelphia. Scott Palmer.
Don Tollefson.
Tollefson, I believe, a few other guys.
I understand that Gary Maddox is also with us tonight with his family here.
Center fielder, huh? Guy from the Philly. Well, everybody loves wrestling. Everybody's interested in it, just about. All right, we've got some...
test of strength here.
Very much so.
Looks like you're going to be won easily by the Swede.
You know what I like about this? The fact that, at least superficially, both guys are about the same height. Maybe a slight weight disadvantage here, one way or the other. But knowledge about the same, I would think. So I don't know they're totally equal. Well, it seems so, Gorilla Monster.
Well, I think that... Vachon may have a little edge as far as experience goes. Swede definitely has an edge as far as power and brute strength goes.
Yes, he does. Brute strength.
And if they ever decide to let go and just wail away at each other, we might be bailing out of here, Dick.
Listen,
you're not going to be able to hide behind me tonight.
People have heard me tell it time and time again, but when you were wrestling about 4 years ago, I remember you came over top rope right down on top of where I was. And
I was aiming for you, Dick, but
thanks
I didn't get you.
Thank you.
Look at this.
Oh, coming our way. There he is, a shot from our ringside camera. Rubbing the eye right along the top rope. And what a nasty guy is Butcher Paul Vachon. And a forearm to the head of Swede Hanson. That's more of a slap. And another chop. Down to one knee, bounces up. Hanging on the top second ropes now on the other side of the ring.
It's a mistake on the part of Vachon here, Dick. In a wrestling match, he stood a chance. In a brawl, he doesn't.
Well, he's playing games. He raked, not that this is such a nice game, but he raked his claws, his nails across the back of Swede Hanson.
You get the Swede riled up.
You bet.
Out in the street, I want him on my side. I know that. They make doorways where there aren't any. Dusty doing a little house cleaning in there.
Well, he may do a lot of it before the night's over. The World Wrestling Federation program, a real stunner. Bill Zacco strikes again. The Invaders against Mr. Fuji, Charlie Fulton. Santana against the Iron Sheik for the big belt. It's a one-hour time limit. Bellomo and Don Morocco going for the Intercontinental title. Bob Backlund, the Max Superstar. Wow, man, I'm telling you. Got the midgets tonight and... the eight-man tag team match. Andre the Giant.
That's a two out of three faller, too.
Yeah, man. It really is. The Samoans, Sergeant
Slaughter. We might be here till tomorrow morning.
Superfly Jimmy Snuka's here. Rocky Johnson. Tony Atlas, my man. They're all here. Oh! That ring jump about a foot. Vachon slammed into the corner by the likes of Swede Hanson. Time over in the other corner now.
He just straightened it out. He moved it back. Moved the ring about 6 inches.
Coming right our way.
Back.
Whoa, back body
big
drop.
Big back drop. Woo. Holy macro. Goodbye. This is over.
Oh, maybe. Maybe.
This is over. Right now.
One, two. Nobody home. All right. That's it.
No way you can come back from that back drop, Dick. No way. Look at Vachon still laying there. That knocked him right for a loop.
It really did.
Oh, I told you not to rile a big guy.
No, sir. And you're right. You're prophetic. And I didn't say pathetic. You're prophetic. And that guy, he must have gone about 5 feet off the doggone scene before he hit the ground. I'm telling you.
The time of the fall wrestling claims 4 minutes, 1 second. Your winner, North Carolina, Swede Hanson.
Hanson, very funny, barely shows any emotion at all.
4 minutes and 1 second.
One fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right from Montreal, Canada, weighing 282 pounds, it is Butcher Paul Vachon. And his opponent in the corner to my left, from Tocula, Mexico, weighing 235 pounds, it is Tito Santana.
Santana, one of the favorites. You see the poster here moments ago, sensational Santana. He is just that. And perhaps destined to be Intercontinental Champion. Who knows? Here we go with the action.
The Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. Another outstanding professional wrestling spectacular. Tomorrow afternoon, Sunday, January 22nd, beginning at 1:30 p.m. Rowdy Roddy Piper, a controversial man, no doubt, will be on the card. In addition, you'll see Don Kernodle, sensational Tito Santana, King Kong Angelo Mosca, and a whole host more. Tomorrow afternoon, mark the starting time down in Toronto at Maple Leaf Gardens, 1:30 p.m.
Vachon with a very nice drop toe hold moments ago on Santana. Sit out by Santana. Oh, nicely done. Almost a whizzer.
See a 282-pound man like Vachon move in the ring. You've got to be impressed.
Vachon, a couple of weeks ago, giving Superfly Snuka a real run for his money. He is the veteran, Vachon, from the Vachon family of wrestling.
Breaks the back with the fingernails of Tito Santana. And again, there's the reprimandation from the referee. Totally justified.
In the breadbasket goes Santana. Another shot in a sizable breadbasket of Vachon. Backs him off now with a kick to the midsection. Ball through with a right to the chest, and Vachon goes for the ride.
And a whip rocking Butcher Vachon, Tito Santana. Temper of his sometimes.
Distracted by the referee inadvertently, actually. And Butcher Paul Vachon, the opportunist that he is, certainly taking advantage of it.
Breaking those eyes across the top rope. Santana to shake it off. Now Vachon fights. Santana counters with an elbow and a couple of boots and an uppercut.
Pick up, what a slam! Drop kick nails the Butcher.
Look at this! Oh,
forget about it. Covers Vachon. One, two, and a three count.
What a very, very impressive victory for the sensational Tito Santana, numero uno.
Yes,
and his
sir.
Fans are here ringside this week.
We get the official time.
It is a time, 2 minutes and 20 seconds, on the winner, Tito Santana.
Santana gets the Duke.
What an explosion of humanity demonstrated beyond belief for the great Tito Santana in victory over Paul the Butcher Vachon.
All right,
McMahon.
Let's take a look now at what we saw moments ago. And there, Vachon really moving in on Santana. I think it only served to raise his ire more than anything else. And out of that corner, here comes Santana with all kinds of fire. Slams the big Butcher down to the canvas. Santana now with a drop kick. Vachon will remember for some time to come.
Watch
off
this.
The rope and, oh, wow, right to the head. Santana on the victory. For the benefit of those of you who'd like to drop us a line this week. That's Eddie Gilbert, Dunster. From Lexington, Tennessee, at 227 pounds, not the biggest man in the World Wrestling Federation, but he is all heart. Gilbert,
squaring up against a 273-pounder and big pusher, Paul Vachon.
Wrestling. My name is Jeremy Q, your ring announcer. And the opening contest, it is a tag team match scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left, from Montreal, Canada, weighing in at 282 pounds, here is Butcher Paul Vachon. And his partner from Nice, France, weighing 245 pounds, here is Rene Goulet. And their opponents from Tacula, Mexico, weighing 235 pounds, here is Tito Santana. And his partner from the French Alps, weighing 490 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant.
There's a look at Andre along with Tito Santana. I believe the first time in which they have had the occasion to team up, without a doubt, one of the great tag team combinations. At least on paper, we'll see how well they can function as a unit. We're ready for the action to begin.
Ladies and gentlemen, the excitement is building. The momentum is catching on fast. 1 week from tonight, on Saturday, February 25th, the World Wrestling Federation returns anew to the Olympic Auditorium, and Hulkamania will undoubtedly be running wild because the incredible Hulk Hogan will be front and center to defend the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Championship against the masked superstar. And it all happens next Saturday night at the Olympic.
Shoulder block by Santana. Coming up again over his bed. Now Goulet spins around. A flying head scissor by Santana. Another one. Santana all over Goulet.
Look at this great star out of Mexico. Going to work at a veteran. The great European veteran out of East France. Rene Goulet. Head scissor Santana. For the Frenchman.
This copyrighted telecast being brought to you by the authority of the World Wrestling Federation. I'd like to remind you that any rebroadcasts were of the use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the telecast, including the imposition of a charge, without the express written consent of the World Wrestling Federation and Titan Sports Incorporated, is prohibited.
Well, the main event, anywhere that I've traveled, you're seeing it right now. As part of championship wrestling, Tito Santana, side headlock on Rene Goulet. Goulet from Nice, France, 245 pounds, whips Santana into the ropes.
Oh, can't get him over.
Wait,
Goulet goes back up. Well, they can't get him one way. Santana's lucky to get him another.
Well, Santana had Goulet shouldered out of the canvas. Two count and a very quick roll on the part of Goulet. Saved him from a possible pinfall this week. World Wrestling Federation action in progress. Side headlock and a hip lock takedown. Goulet, but Santana right back with that head scissors. Santana right now exchanging a little dialogue with his tag team partner. Eighth wonder of the world, as Joe McHugh would say, the one, the only, the inimitable Andre the Giant. Santana still retaining that head scissors on Goulet. Goulet's partner to the left of your screen, Paul the Butcher Vachon, another great ring veteran from Montreal, La Belle Province, Quebec, in Canada.
Santana has to feel pretty good in there at the moment. Knowing full well that behind him is Dan. Oh,
wow. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Butcher. Lowering the boom on Santana. Double team and double slam. Andre steps over the top rope. And back over now. Referee trying to maintain a semblance of order. Fletcher, Vachon going to work with the boots. A series of boots to the head, but Santana comes back right to the midsection. Andre the Giant. Going to work, taking them both out.
Santana back in now. Look at this. What a chance.
Talk about teamwork. Two, three, it's all over. What an unbelievable pinfall for the team of Santana and the Giant. Look at these fans this week.
Look at the official time.
Here is the time. 4 minutes and 14 seconds. Here are the winners. Andre the Giant, Tito Santana.
This capacity crowd certainly enjoying the tag team efforts of Santana and Andre the Giant. Perhaps we shall see them in the future, in more tag team action as we take a look, Gene, at what we saw moments ago.
All right, Andre the Giant whips Butcher Vachon into the ropes. Here's the big boot now, grating Vachon. And, of course, that absolutely polarizes Vachon. And now take a look at this very, very unique move. Andre throwing Tito Santana on Vachon and the subsequent 1-2-3 pinfall.
Back up now for our... There's the Polish power, Ivan Putski, originally from Krakow, Poland, 246 pounds, setting his sights on a big Andre at 277 from Montreal, Canada. Putski, call for sure. Butcher goes downstairs on Ivan. You know, Putski is just made out of crap. It's incredible, Gene, how much punishment Ivan Putski can absorb. Now, look at that.
Vachon trying to find a place to hide. Uh-oh, wait a minute now. With just a minute, Vachon risking disqualification.
Let me put the count on the Butcher, he drops the chair.
Very terrible individual, Ivan Putski. And has he shared of the American dream?
Terrible. You bet he has. Putski. In a standing position now, Butcher Vachon with the side headlock. Ivan trying to position the Butcher, does indeed. Shoves him to the rope now, off and down goes Ivan. 277 pounds coming at him. And again. Oh, Vachon off in.
Oh, Butcher Vachon's face.
Such is the power of Ivan Putski. Vachon, luckily for him, grabbing the top rope. Referee asking for the clean break.
Breaks the eyes. And again. There's the ripple man. But on three, now breaking the back. Look at that
back. The Boston crowd looking on. Putski's manicure is after that.
Beautiful.
Ivan now. Look at Ivan. Little razzle dazzle.
Can he electrify a crowd?
And back to the corner now. Big Butcher Vachon. Not for long. Whip to the far side. Ivan grabs him again. And puts him to the near side. Oh, wow. Oh, the hammer. Covers him. He gets it just like that. Harvard Putski running around the ring.
And obviously, that beats with the approval of this capacity crowd here this week at All-Star with Holy Smoke.
Look at this.
You can't say Michonne didn't ask for it.
That's right. Oh, wow. Michonne on the outside and a bouncing Ivan Putski victorious. Michonne says, heck of that, I bet
I really can't blame him. A bundle of energy, very popular wherever he goes. Ivan Putski.
Next week, ladies and gentlemen, we will look forward to what will no doubt be one of the greatest one-on-one confrontations we've ever had the pleasure to present to you on All-Star Wrestling. And I'll tell you, Gene, what's your reaction to that?
Well, it's great that we can share it with our television audience. Of course, everybody knows what has happened here over the past few weeks. Sergeant Slaughter and Iron Sheik, no love lost between these two men. Now they're going to have an opportunity to settle any issues, any and all issues, that exist between the front of the national television audience.
And you can bet that Sergeant Slaughter will be ready for the confrontation, and just as ready will be the Iron Sheik. Till then, look at Prince McMahon, along with me, Gene Oberlin, saying so long from retirement.
Contest. This is the one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left from Montreal, Canada, weighing in at 282 pounds, here is Butcher Paul Vachon. And his opponent in the corner to my right from Italy, weighing in at 230 pounds, here is Salvatore Bellomo.
Salvatore Bellomo being greeted by some of the fans about ringside. Mr. Bellomo, a longtime favorite in the World Wrestling Federation. Very scientifically oriented wrestler. Should be an outstanding matchup with the Big Butcher.
Ladies and gentlemen, there are still choice tickets available for tonight's card of World Wrestling Federation action at the Olympic Auditorium beginning at 8 p.m. Pick up the tickets at the Olympic box office. A big night featuring Adrian Adonis against Superfly Snuka, Mil Mascaras battling Iron Mike Sharp. Tito Santana, the return Texas death match, defends the Intercontinental title against the magnificent Morocco. And it's the incredible Hulk Hogan in the main event tonight at the Olympic meeting the masked superstar.
Butcher Paul Vachon continuing his attack on Salvatore Bellomo. Bellomo goes downstairs, found a soft spot, another one. Back on his feet now, Bellomo, Herring and Murray, and coming right in on Butcher Paul Vachon. Down he goes.
Snap there. Oh, boots across the head of Butcher Vachon. Salvatore Bellomo with a forearm.
I'll tell you, there have been some great matches over the last few years in the World Wrestling Federation here on Championship Wrestling, but I'll tell you, look at that drop kick in the midsection. Next week, Gene, I think we have the makings of one of the greatest matches ever on television with the Iron Sheik against Sergeant Slaughter.
Well, the talk has already started, not only here, but throughout the wrestling world. The fact that it's going to be the Iron Sheik now accepting the challenge, as we know, of Sergeant Slaughter. And it is going to be some kind of a match. I guarantee you the animosity is quite obvious in what we've seen over the past few weeks.
Freddie Fosse was not reluctant, I might add, to sign the contract at all. So apparently Fosse feels the Iron Sheik will do a number on Sergeant Slaughter.
That I will have to see. In my opinion, of course, Slaughter, one of the best big men in professional wrestling. Oh! Vachon going to work on the native of Sicily, Salvatore Bellomo. But also in his own right, you've got the Iron Sheik, a former Olympian, and a man who has got that scientific technique down pat. He is really a great one.
And former World Wrestling Federation champion. And many say, again, the Sheik will reign as World Wrestling Federation champion.
Oh, look at that move.
You kick nicely done. A big butcher downstairs. The cover by Bellomo. Has him in the cradle, too. And yes, he gets it.
That saves the former Marlin. And the old mule kick executed to perfection by Salvatore Bellomo. Oh, Vachon's still trying to figure out what's going on.
We get the official time. Big Butcher falling on hard time.
Here is the time. 2 minutes and 41 seconds. I'm the winner, Salvatore Bellomo.
Salvatore Bellomo gets the dope. And we'll take a look at what we saw moments ago as Salvatore says hello about with some of the fans about ringside.
All right, there's the whip by Vachon of Bellomo. Into the ropes. Here is the jump over by Salvatore. Now, watch very closely in slow motion. Double mule kick, Bellomo. Oh. And it's all over for Monsieur Vachon, the butcher, Paul Vachon.
Yes, indeed, a victory for Salvatore Bellomo. Of course, earlier on, victorious this week, we saw Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, Frank Valentine, Tito Santana. And quite impressive indeed was the very first appearance of Roddy Piper teaming up with Dr. D. David Schultz. However, everything to a certain extent will pale compared to next week, when indeed next week we shall have one-on-one Sergeant Slaughter, one of the toughest individuals to ever step foot in the squared circle, against the Iron Sheik, former World Wrestling Federation champion. All that and more next.
Gentlemen, the next contest, it is a six-man tag team match scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left, from Montreal, Canada, weighing 282 pounds, here is Butcher Paul Vachon. And from Nice, France, weighing in at 245 pounds, here is Rene Goulet. And from Hollywood, California, weighing 230 pounds, here is Goldie Rogers. And the team in the corner of my right, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 240 pounds, here is SD Special Delivery Jones. And his partners of the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, from Roanoke, Virginia, weighing 250 pounds, here is Tony Atlas. And from Washington, D.C., weighing in at 250 pounds, here is Rocky Johnson.
What a tag team combination, these three individuals. Wait a minute now, Rene Goulet wanting to start things off, and our ring announcer, Joe McHugh, who's almost involved in a brawl there. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, in just a few short weeks, the brand new World Wrestling Federation magazine will be on the stands, and I can tell you this, it's going to be one of the best publications ever seen. If you'd like to become a charter subscriber to this great publication, all you have to do is send check or money order for $14.47 for 8 action-packed issues to WWF Magazine, Post Office Box 1538, Greenwich, Connecticut, 06836.
And back in the ring now, Tony Atlas and Goulet. It was Goulet who went after Atlas earlier on before the match began. Has him back in the corner and hammering away now. Tag has made the big Butcher step through, and Butcher Paul Vachon catching the Rock there. Double team effort. Finally, the referee gets Goulet out of the ring.
Rocky Johnson right now setting Vachon up for the whip into the turnbuckles, and what a jarring.
Look at that
head.
Atlas comes in and caught from behind, tags out quickly. SD now with the Big Butcher.
The tag, Vachon, to Goldie Rogers out of Hollywood, California. Shades of Hollywood indeed.
Rogers locking up with special delivery now, and SD giving him a headbutt, and Rogers goes down to the canvas.
Oh, that headbutt. Rocking Goldie Rogers. Tag very quickly.
Atlas now with Rogers and whips him to the rope, and oh, bends him over, that he does. Atlas now with Rogers in the air. And way in the air, and pandemonium has broken loose. Look at that. Referee, one, two, and lights out.
Something else. What a package. Tony Atlas taking Rogers high in the air. And did you see that slam, Vince McMahon?
That came from the top of the Empire State Building. Let's get the official time.
Here is the time, 2:04. Here are the winners, S.D. Jones, Tony Atlas, Rocky Johnson.
Well, fantastic teamwork on the part of the trio of Jones, Johnson, and Atlas. And it proved beneficial as they went on to victory.
For the benefit of those of you who'd like to drop us a line this week, as you know, we encourage that on every occasion. Later on, we shall be reading you some of the comments and questions that you have written in. We invite you to write us here to Wrestling, P.O. Box 1538, Greenwich, Connecticut, 06836. Stay with us. Scheduled up next over most of these same stations, a most interesting interview. Greg Valentine to join us, and of course, Piper's Pit with his guest, Tony Garea, and then the big one's going to come along. We'll be back. In the ring in a moment, ladies and gentlemen, the tag team combination of Tony Garea and Brian Blair. Garea in the blue tights, Blair, of course, in the red tights. Both gentlemen around the 237-pound mark as now we look at their opponents, Butcher Paul Vachon at 267 pounds, and his tag team partner, Ron Shaw, at 260. So the beef, obviously, on the side of Vachon and Shaw, should be an outstanding tag team matchup. Ron Shaw with a nice go-behind. Oh, however, Tony Garea very nicely executes the escape. Garea and Blair coming into their own as tag team partners as of late. Really doing well.
Well, I'm certainly impressed. They do, in fact, Vince McMahon, compliment each other beautifully. Garea, that tremendous experience as you see him apply. First, the full Nelson, then a very quick flying mare. Step over with a wrist and a tag to be Brian Blair. Blair from Tampa, Florida, off the ropes as he comes in, greets Mr. Shaw with a flying elbow. And take a look at this. Spinning on the arm, followed by another flying elbow drop. Blair, tremendous credentials. Fireman's carry and a takedown. Armbar, pick up, Shaw, oh, and Blair held on. Continuing to maintain control.
Ron Shaw and Butcher Paul Vachon have teamed up in the past with a checkered record of success as we look at this capacity crowd looking on, and it's back in now. Mr. Brian Blair against the veteran Butcher Paul Vachon. Off the rope now. Oh, my! What a chest! Nicely done! And up goes the big Butcher down to the canvas. Brian Blair with an elbow. One, two, and comes it hook the leg, and you have to do that with those big men. Ooh. Able to tag out. just in the nick of time as Tony Garea comes in now. And Butcher catches Garea with a series of blows.
Breaks the eyes.
And Vachon tagging out. Why would you want to tag out when you have the advantage like that, Gene?
I don't know. I have to question that particular move. Maybe the very quick respite on the part of Vachon. He's packing a lot of beef, as you alluded to earlier.
Indeed, he may have been tiring. Well, right now, Ron Shaw is not doing all that well for himself. Garea hammering away. Oh, my. Vachon was coming over to help out. Brian Blair has things in control. It looks like all four men in the ring. Look out. Trouble headed to cover. Now it's Ron Shaw in there with both Garea and Blair. Over he goes, abdominal stretch. He may nail him. Yes, he's got the hands hooked and cinched in well. And yes, that's it. It's all over.
Well, the octopus on the abdominal stretch, absolutely too much for Ron Shaw. Tony Garea just executing to perfection. And Shaw had to submit. This team, very, very impressive. They're going to be heard from in the World Wrestling Federation.
Perhaps championship bound. Next week, ladies and gentlemen, to join us, the Iron Sheik to meet Eddie Gilbert. That should be a sensational matchup. We shall all so have with us next week, Tiger Chung Lee, Mr. Fuji, along with a special midget tag team matchup as Tiger Jackson and the Haiti Kid square off against Dana Carpenter and Poncho Boy. Also, Dr. D, David Schultz, perhaps in his own right, championship bound, will be with us. Along with Salvatore Bellomo, the mass superstar, and the newly crowned Intercontinental Champion, Tito Santana. Join us next week.
This is Dick Graham with Gorilla Monsoon at the Spectrum. And now let's learn what's next.
Wrestling fans, this next event is a one-fall contest with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first from Montreal, Canada, weighing 282 pounds, the Montreal Express Butcher, Paul Vachon. His opponent hails from Italy, weighing 237 pounds, Salvatore Bellomo.
Well, all out booze. Whoa! What happens here? Underway without any prior warning. There's the bell now. Already it started. Vachon taking off after Bellomo. Bellomo stunned. Smashed into the turnbuckle, down on one knee, and Vachon is on a tear, and is tearing at the back of Bellomo. Going for the eyes of Bellomo. Going for the eyes again of Bellomo. The midsection. Woo! Vachon must have a plane to catch. Going after Bellomo in the far corner.
Boyd really going to work on him right off the bat. No hesitation whatsoever.
He wants to get it over with fast.
Bellomo off the top turnbuckle. Nobody there off the second turnbuckle.
Jarred is back on that one. Bellomo coming off the ropes. We've seen him do that time and time again successfully.
Vachon still pounding on him.
Pounding him down to the... Well, he's back up again.
Reverse. Reverse neck breaker here. The hangman, it's called. Bellomo right up over the top. Beautiful maneuver into a small package. He could get him here. He got him.
He did.
Woo. All right. You talk about fast. Here I thought Vachon wanted to get it over with fast. But Bellomo did a tap dance in his head. I mean, Bellomo is exultant.
Tables turned in a hurry. Let's get the official time.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the fall, 1:09. Your winner, Salvatore Bellomo.
Vachon, so disgusted
with himself, maybe, or the decision, or both. He didn't waste any. He's gone. He took off. He couldn't take it. Very disturbed. I think he's very disturbed with himself. He had some action going for himself.
Well, he didn't make a mistake. Look, he went for this beautiful hangman here, reverse neck breaker. Salvatore just kips right up. Beautiful maneuver. Slides right over to that small package.
Pull the leg up. Got him. Nailed him.
Got the big three.
Zapparino.
With a 10-minute time limit, introducing in the corner of my left, from Montreal, Canada, weighing in at 282 pounds, it is Butcher Paul Vachon. And his opponent from the Fiji Islands, weighing 50 pounds. Here is Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
My goodness, look at this crowd. Are they ever supportive of the Superfly? Snuka, one of the most extraordinary athletes in the World Wrestling Federation today. He has his work cut out for him, however, this week against Big Butcher Paul Vachon. Vachon, Gene, with the decided weight advantage.
Well, no question about that. However, there's no doubt in anybody's mind a capability of Superfly.
Oh, look at that! Oh, Vachon coming in behind and going to work on the Superfly.
Again, we remind you, the World Wrestling Federation magazine, not that far away from hitting the Los Angeles area. From the incredible Hulk Hogan to Andre the Giant to Sergeant Slaughter to Superfly Snuka, all of your favorites are in this great issue. If you would like to subscribe, again, we remind you, 8 action-packed issues for only $14.47. Send check or money order for that amount to WWF Magazine, Post Office Box 1538, Greenwich, Connecticut, 06836.
Snuka slamming Big Butcher Paul Vachon, and Snuka has had the best in the last couple of minutes of this match for sure. Another huge slam. Snuka now. Wait a minute. There's Lou Albano out there.
What is Albano doing out here, Vince?
Snuka on his way to the top rope. He hasn't even seen Albano yet. Snuka, oh, what a headbutt. Oh, my. Albano out on the apron.
I don't understand it. What in the world is Lou Albano doing out here?
Snuka. Snuka out on the apron. Lou Albano headed back to the dressing room area. I would suspect that. No, here he comes. Here he comes. Snuka gets a shot at.
Get the official time.
Now here is the time. 1 minute and 34 seconds on the winner. Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Well, that weight advantage of Paul Vachon, the Butcher, really not paying off in this particular instance, Vince.
Indeed not. The Superfly with another great victory. Let's go back, take a look at what we saw now. Here up on the top rope. He's distracted now by Albano. He looked right over that way and came down with a headbutt on Vachon. Otherwise, he may have gone for the body splash. Nonetheless, the headbutt certainly enough to put the Big Butcher away. For the benefit of those of you who'd like to drop us a line this week on Championship Wrestling, as in every week, we wholeheartedly encourage you to do so.
And now, as Frank Ruiz backs off from Big Butcher Paul Vachon. And Vachon, no doubt, will attempt to assert himself as he does on almost every occasion.
Among some of the other greats that have been signed to appear on the World Wrestling Federation Spectacular at the Olympic Auditorium on the 28th of April include Big John Studd. In addition, to Superfly Jimmy Snuka and Mr. Pat Patterson. Not to forget the contest between the masked superstar and Salvatore Bellomo. It comes at the Olympic Auditorium, the next World Wrestling Federation event of Saturday night, April 28th.
Vachon with a kick to the face.
Vince correspondence coming in from Don Doherty, Palestine, Illinois, suburban Chicago. Dear Vince and Gene, many of us here in Illinois marvel at the sight of Tony Mr. USA Atlas's physique. Do either of you happen to know how many years of training it took for Tony to reach his build? He sure is a physical specimen, from Don Doherty, Palestine, Illinois. Vince, you know the answer to that one.
Well, I think Atlas has spent just the better part of his entire life in the gymnasium.
No. Absolutely, a lifetime. It starts from day one.
And on the mat as well. Atlas with no doubt God-given gifts, as well as the ones that he has to work the hardest for.
Frank Ruiz.
Look at this. Vachon pulls over Ruiz with a yank of the hair. Ooh, kick to the face.
Vachon, tremendously brutal tactics. That's being demonstrated quite clearly on Mr. Ruiz from Chicago, Illinois.
Vachon, however, reversed, and Ruiz runs into the foot of Vachon. Vachon, oh no!
Nearly 300 pounds to the midsection, the hook, and a three count victory for Paul the Butcher Vachon.
Boy, I'll say, Vachon wiping his hands as if he has laid them on so much garbage. The Butcher peering back. Let's get the official time.
Here's the time, 3 minutes and 4 seconds, on the winner, Butcher Paul Vachon.
Very impressive victory for Paul Vachon.
Mr. Vachon using his decided weight advantage there as he literally jumped into the midsection of his opponent, Frank Ruiz.
Right from Montreal, Canada, weighing 272 pounds, here is Butcher Paul Vachon. And his opponent from South Carolina, weighing 296 pounds, here is Butcher.
Great American, Sergeant Slaughter, snaps off a salute. Charge reviewing the colors moments ago. Terry Daniels, of course, the first inductee into Sergeant Slaughter's, how about that, into Sergeant Slaughter's Cobra Corps. And the Sarge now ready to lock up. With a big man in his office. Hello there.
Look at there.
Look there. That general's.
Oh, my
nice,
goodness.
Nice, nice promotion.
Great. Well, that was, huh? If you can get it.
Old Glory, lying in the background. First, Terry Daniels. Looking on, I'm sure. Likeness there of Sergeant Slaughter. All right, Butcher Paul Vachon now ready to lock up with Sergeant Slaughter. Should be a great one.
Whenever the World Wrestling Federation appears at the Olympic Auditorium, you can be sure that only the best in mat action will follow. And just signed to the card of Saturday night, June 30th, Big John Studd. this man never seems to get worse. He gets better. He is like a fine wine, because every time he steps into the Olympic ring as of late, he is certainly more impressive and more awesome than ever. Big John Studd, literally a big part of the Olympic Auditorium wrestling card of Saturday, June 30th.
Oh my goodness, Butcher Paul Vachon back up now. Blassie, along with the Iron Sheik, out taking a look at Sergeant Slaughter's match. And they better take a good look at the Sarge, I'll tell you. Sarge with a nice maneuver there on Butcher Paul Vachon. I think Sarge has just noticed the Iron Sheik. And that, I would think, will no doubt be quite a distraction, Gene.
Well, it's got to be.
Look at that from behind. Butcher Paul Vachon attacking Sergeant Slaughter, who no doubt was distracted by the Iron Sheik. And Sergeant hammering away on Butcher Paul Vachon. Big Butcher now in the air, slammed to the canvas by Sergeant Slaughter, who looks over. Wait a minute.
Now he's pointing at the Sheik. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, Vince. I think they got to.
Okay.
Terry Daniels, my word.
Sure.
I can't. I think the Sheik got to Terry Daniels and leveled him.
Incredible, Sergeant Slaughter.
Okay.
Let's get the meanwhile back in the ring, ladies and gentlemen.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Sergeant Slaughter was counted out outside the ring. Here is the winner, Booker.
Wait a minute, Sarge on the big Butcher. Sarge is really angry. And take a look at what we saw just moments ago. Here, the Iron Sheik and Freddie Blassie looking on now. And this is, give me a break. Terry Daniels standing out of tension. And look at this. Oh, he just drove a knee right in the midsection. Incredible. The Iron Sheik driving a knee right into the midsection. Terry Daniels, Sergeant Slaughter to the rescue, nonetheless counted out. Let's go now to Gene Okerlund.
I think of Vince McMahon, Sergeant Slaughter, what happened?
Iron Sheik, you maggot scum. I'm in the ring wrestling. You come out here, I don't care if you watch me all night. You can do that all you want. Maybe you'll learn something about wrestling. But don't you lay a hand on Terry Daniels, my recruit, because I'm going to tear your head off. I'm going to make you bleed.
Wait a minute, let's clarify one thing. Sergeant Slaughter did, in fact, the Iron Sheik take a shot here at your man,
put a knee right in his gut.
Oh, I can't believe it.
Thank God Terry Daniels was a Marine. Thank God he's joined the Cobra Corps, because you notice that American flag did not touch the ground. His hat fell on the ground, but the Old Glory never hit the ground. Let me tell you, Iron Sheik, the war is still on, my buddy, old pal.
have to cut you short. Thank you, Sergeant Slaughter, making his point, obviously, totally unhappy with the actions of the Iron Sheik this week. Back to you, Vince McMahon.
Oh, my goodness. Terry Daniels trying to bring All Glory back up to where she belongs. Still hurting in the midsection. Sergeant Slaughter to the rescue.
And Orton doing a fantastic job.
This contest scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. To my right, from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, weighing 279 pounds, Butcher Vachon. His opponent, from Princeton, Minnesota, weighing 234 pounds, the former World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion, Bob Backlund.
Capacity crowd on hand this week in a World Wrestling Federation, but it's one fall match between Butcher Paul Vachon and this man, Bob Backlund. Just a little aside here, I think Vachon could probably be spending a little more time in the gym.
That's obvious.
Controlling up that 279 pound frame of his.
He moves it around fairly well.
Well, I'll tell you what, he makes the most of that weight.
Backlund is going to be just 100 times quicker than Vachon.
Well, he's quick like a cat. That.
World Wrestling Federation continuing to bring you the best in professional wrestling, as is in evidence.
Bob Backlund, 234 pounds, and look at that move. That has got Vachon somewhat frustrated.
Backlund has that deceiving power, Gene. Doesn't look like he possesses that great strength,
but there.
Believe me, he does.
It's there.
I've seen him do some phenomenal things.
You know, Backlund, not so much of a weightlifter as he is into calisthenics and a number of other things. We've seen him use that wheel, certainly for the...
And that Harvard step test, he broke how many records doing that? I remember we asked him one time at a TV taping session, Gene, to do that. He said, I'll be glad to do it for an hour, but I did it for an hour this morning already. And he went ahead. In other words, he did it for 2 hours that day. Talk about conditioning.
A shot of big, powerful Butcher Paul Vachon. A couple of shots to the throat, forearm to the upper back. There's a forearm uppercut, followed by another right to the midsection. Now Vachon is taking with that 279 pounds behind it.
Backlund going for the ride. Oh, he hit hard.
There's a shoulder that hits home to the midsection.
Unbelievable wrestling family, the Vachons, Gene.
Indeed.
Holy macro history. Reversal now by Backlund. And a look out!
Oh. Hold on!
Look at Backlund holding him up there.
He's going to bring him down!
Oh.
You know, you mentioned...
Chicken wing, cross face!
Cross face, chicken wing. Vachon has got absolutely no chance. There have been few who have escaped from that one. How much pain can Vachon tolerate? That's got to be tremendously painful.
He's got it on there pretty good. The only salvation for Vachon would be that he reached the ropes.
Oh, the referee says, ring the bell.
That's it. He's not going to reach the ropes.
It is all over. Vachon on the receiving end of some tremendous punishment in the hands of Bob Backlund getting the Duke.
Let's get the official word.
The winner of this bout, Bob Backlund.
than an evening of professional heavyweight wrestling. This is the first event of the evening. One fall with three all, weighing 285 pounds, Paul Butcher Vachon. The referee, Fred Atkins, one fall, 20-minute time limit.
Well, this is Jack Reynolds at ringside along with Billy Red Lyons. Billy, we've got the Butcher in our first match, our first exciting match.
Yes, this should be a real barn burner, Jack. Paul Butcher Vachon, one of the ring generals, you might say, in the profession today, going up against a young fellow from Calgary, Alberta, Bret Hart. Bret Hart, as you know, Jack, is the son of a former wrestling great, Stu Hart, who is truly a legend throughout Western Canada. So, Bret Hart, I would say Jack should have the edge here because he comes from a family of wrestlers, and like I said, his father's one of the all-time greats, and so he's been well-trained.
All right, the match officially underway. And Butcher Vachon going against Bret Hart. This, by the way, will be a one fall with a 30-minute time limit.
That's right, Jack. And as usual, another tremendous crowd on hand here tonight in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. And, Jack, I think, I know you agree with me that the Maple Leaf Gardens, it's the home of professional wrestling throughout Canada.
This has always been one of the great places for professional wrestling throughout the entire world with all the superstars of professional wrestling at one time or another here at the famed Maple Leaf Gardens. Right now, Bret Hart in command of this bout against the Butcher. You know, the one thing that impresses me, Billy Red Lyons, is the fact that not only is Butcher Vachon, not only does he come from a great wrestling family and has a lot of ring experience behind him, but he is also a fine vocalist.
Yes.
If you had the opportunity, I had the opportunity several weeks ago of watching him perform, and he has got a pretty good voice.
He certainly has, and, you know, to look at him, judging by his appearance, like you said, Jack, I'm sure that a lot of the people out there aren't aware of the fact that he has such a good singing voice, but you wouldn't expect it from someone like Butcher Vachon.
Right now, the Butcher with a headlock on his younger opponent.
Oh, a nice move by Bret Hart. However, Paul Vachon resorted to a handful of hair to get himself out of trouble there. Fred Atkins was right on top of the situation and immediately broke it, Jack.
Vachon with another headlock. Referee Freddie Atkins looking over the situation. Oh, a little hair pulling there by the Butcher. And a hard right hand to the head.
And Fred Atkins, there we see him, Jack, warns Butcher Vachon once again about the fist and using the hair. However, Bret Hart comes back with a hard kick to the midsection, and the big man, Paul Vachon, backs into the corner.
Good maneuvering in there right now by young Hart.
Another clever maneuver by Bret Hart.
Good wrist lock in there by Hart on the Butcher. And a hard right hand to the back of the neck.
Oh, and he straightens it out there. A little hyperextension on the elbow. And that always smarts, Jack.
Referee Fred Atkins right now checking with the Butcher. The Butcher says, no way. Another tremendous crowd in attendance this evening here at the beautiful Maple Leaf Gardens.
That's right, Jack, and every time we have professional wrestling in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens, always have a tremendous crowd on hand. And like you mentioned earlier, all the stars in the World Wrestling Federation are going to be seen here in the gardens at one time or other. Everyone that means something in professional wrestling today, sooner or later, they come to Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens.
The greatest professional wrestlers in the world today representing the World Wrestling Federation.
And Bret Hart still with the upper hand on Paul Vachon. However, Vachon Throws one to the midsection. Now rakes him up the back with his nails. And another one to the back of Bret Hart. Paul Vachon now taking over, Jack.
The Butcher is coming on. Oh, tremendous right hand in there by Butcher Vachon, and Hart goes down. Boy, you could hear that one up in row Z.
Now the Butcher goes to work on the trapezius muscle of Bret Hart. Force him down the knee. You know, Jack, Butcher Vachon here, by all rights, he shouldn't have any trouble with Bret Hart. Just shows you the condition that Bret Hart is in. He outweighs him by what around 50 pounds.
Right around 50 pounds, right. 235 pounds for young Hart and 285, the Butcher checking in tonight.
Oh, and look at that slam by Bret Hart.
Beautiful body slam in there by Hart. A leg drop. Try for a press. Atkins a little slow getting over there, Billy Red Lions.
Yes, just a mite slow, yes. And another driving slam by Bret Hart. And Bret Hart definitely in the driver's seat now. Jack goes on top once again for the pin. Fred Atkins is there this time. However, the Butcher gets the foot on the bottom rope.
Tremendous elbow smash in there by young Hart on the Butcher. The Butcher was able to reach the ring ropes, causing referee Freddie Atkins to break the hold. The Butcher coming back in now. And Hart is ready to go right after him again.
And you notice, Jack, the Butcher a little wobbly on his legs after taking those two slams. Oh, and a backdrop by Bret Hart. Jack, how high would you say the Butcher went in the air on that one?
He was up there. He was flying.
Now Hart picks him up, flying there him into the center of the ring.
Hart likes to work the elbow smashes pretty good.
Yes, he does. He gets everything into those elbows.
Young Bret Hart, one of the new coming stars in the world of professional wrestling. World Wide Wrestling Federation.
One of the more popular young wrestlers in Western Canada, Bret Hart.
Referee Freddie Atkins checking with the Butcher right now as Hart applies the pressure. There it is. Looks like some sort of a front face chin lock in there by Hart. Oh, yes. Good maneuver in there by the Butcher. And a nice takedown.
Now the Butcher picks up Bret Hart, sends him into the ropes, and catches him right in the throat area. Coming off, down he goes to the mat. Fred Atkins is there because it's a deliberate choke by the Butcher, Jack.
No question about it. The Butcher using all of his ring savvy right now against his younger opponent, Bret Hart.
And the Butcher comes down with a hard shot right to the face of Bret Hart.
Right now, the Butcher taking command once again of this bout as his younger opponent is trying to pick himself up, get himself together again.
Whoa! Once again, goes to work on that trapezius muscle, Jack. Fred Atkins is right there on top of the situation, making sure the Butcher doesn't slip a chokehold in while the referee's back is turned. And there, you see the handful of hair on the blind side of the referee, Jack. The Butcher, he knows all the tricks, all the ins and outs, doesn't he?
He is what you call a cagey veteran. He's been around the ring wars for quite some time. Still working on that trapezius muscle.
Yes, and he has Bret Hart, you know, he has all that downward pressure now. Bret Hart is back to his feet. And the Butcher throws him in the ropes, catches him right in the throat area once again. And now throws him back into the ropes, and once again, we see the Butcher has Bret Hart right in the throat area. Oh, and Bret Hart turns the tables this time, and down goes the Butcher.
You've got to fight fire with fire, and that's what Bret Hart is doing right now.
That's the name of the game. When the going gets tough, the tough get going, right, Jack?
And the crowd loves it.
Oh, a beautiful forearm underneath. Now that staggered the Butcher back into the corner, and Hart comes in with a hard shot to the midsection, steps up on that second rope, and goes to work on that. Head of Butcher Vachon.
Pounding away. Using the ring ropes to his advantage and a whip.
Oh,
that stung.
285 pounds. That moved the ring about 4 or 5 inches. This time the Butcher reverses it, comes in for his shoulder, and a beautiful move by Bret Hart. Rolls him up on his shoulders. The referee is right there, Jack. And this is all over.
That's it. Boy, you talk about a crafty maneuver in there by the youngster, Bret Hart.
The winner of the match at 9 minutes, 14 seconds, Bret Hart.
Billy Red Lions, we've got to take one more look at that great maneuver in there by Bret Hart as he's victorious in his match against Butcher Vachon. There it is. All right. Look at this. The Butcher trying the whip. Now, here's the maneuver. Here it is, up in the air. Look at this. Come on back, Butcher.
Hooks him around the waist, rolls him up on his shoulders, Jack. Hooks the arms with his legs. The referee's right there. And just like that one, Jack,
Bret
Hart puts another one in the win column.
And that's all she wrote. The winner of the fall and the match, Bret Hart.
Montreal, weighing 285 pounds, Paul Butcher Vachon. His opponent. Now entering the ring area. From New Orleans, weighing 260 pounds, the Junkyard Dog.
Crowd loves it. They're going wild. This week. The music keeps playing, and the Junkyard Dog is doing his thing. But this match is officially underway. Once again at ringside, this is Jack Reynolds along with Angelo Mosca. Angelo, should be a great match here.
It should be. All the dancing stopping, and now we're going to start some wrestling.
Paul Vachon, the crafty veteran, against the Junkyard Dog.
The Junkyard Dog's got a great background, too. Also, as a professional football player, play with the Green Bay Packers.
Paul Vachon weighing in at 295 pounds this week. And Junkyard Dog tipping the scales at 262. Your referee for this bout is Terry Yorkston. This is a one fall, 30-minute time limit. Well, Vachon is out of the ring already. There's a good shot of the Junkyard Dog right now, waiting for Vachon to get back into the ring. Angelo, Paul Vachon is, as I have mentioned at the offset of this bout, a crafty veteran.
He sure is a crafty veteran, and you saw what happened earlier in the situation. But Junkyard Dog can hold his own against the veterans as well as the rookies because he's an athlete, as you can see. Look at the powerful shoulders on this man, Jack.
Well, I tell you, that Junkyard Dog is really put together. A little hair pull in there. Raking the eyes. In fact, there he goes, raking the back right now.
I don't think you want to get a dog too mad in this situation.
Not at all. Junkyard Dog reeling right now. There's a tremendous open hand fist to the sternum area of Junkyard Dog. Vachon going to work right now. Now that's uncalled for, Angelo.
Well, sometimes you have to resort to all methods when you see you can't handle a situation. I know you might not agree, Jack, but I've done situations to get myself out of those.
Coming back right now, the Junkyard Dog. Now he's raking at Paul Vachon.
What's fair for the goose is fair for the gander.
Oh, biting the ear of Paul Vachon. Vachon in pain and he wants out. He's out of the ring right now.
think Junkyard Dog was having a little taste of Alpo.
Vachon coming back into the ring right now as referee Terry Yorkston does his count. And the Junkyard Dog goes to work again on Vachon. A whip into the ring. Look at this body slam. Holding him up there. Look at that.
Oh, the big bump.
That's it. Boy, you talk about excitement. The crowd loves it. Quite a maneuver in there.
It sure is. When a man, his dexterity and stamina over 300 pounds can pick up another man over 300 and some pounds and drive him into the mat, if you notice on the back of his trunks, it says Big Thump.
Let's go up to the ring right now for the official decision.
The winner of the match, the Junkyard Dog.
There's your winner. Junkyard Dog victorious in his match against Paul Vachon. Angelo, we have got to take another look at that tremendous movement there by Junkyard Dog as he was victorious in this bout against Paul Vachon.
Look at the power of the shoulders to lift the man over 300 pounds. Here it comes right here, Jack.
You know, we're talking about 295 pounds right there.
Look at that big pump.
What a tremendous move in there by the Junkyard Dog. And let me tell you, he is enjoying it. He's enjoying it. All the...
Ladies and gentlemen, this will be a tag team match. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Montreal, weighing 285 pounds, Paul Butcher Vachon. His partner from Hollywood, California, weighing 235 pounds, Goldie Rogers. Their opponents, with a combined weight of 580 pounds, Afa and Sika, the Wild Samoans.
We've got the Wild Samoans this week.
And while they are
Wrestling Federation,
you know, Jack, these are the Samoans are the ex-World Federation Tag Team Champions.
And what great champions they were.
They sure were.
Representing the World Wrestling Federation. Their opponents this evening, or this week, I should say, on this card, will be the combination of Paul Vachon and Goldie Rogers, hailing from Hollywood, California. There's the bell, the match officially underway. Your referee for this bout is Wayne Cashman. Now, I have to be honest with you, Angelo. I have seen the Samoans wrestle many, many times, but I can't tell these two guys apart.
Now, they almost look like twins, but I'll tell you one thing. They look like they didn't miss too many meals also.
All right, the bell, the match officially underway. Paul Vachon.
You know, these Samoans got great dispositions until you get them riled up. They're like the Polynesians and the Maoris, the extractions in the South Pacific. And if you get these people riled up, you could have a war in your hands or in a luau.
Paul Vachon right now. And one half of these Samoans, I believe that is Afa in the ring right now with Paul Vachon. A whip into the ring ropes. Look at that. Vachon. Oh, nice takeover by Afa.
I'll tell you one thing about the Samoans. They really enjoy themselves.
They are crowd pleasers.
They sure are.
Referee Wayne Cashman right now warning the Samoan about the closed fist. Angelo, there he is again.
Look at the arm on that hillbilly.
My goodness, look at the arms on that guy.
Ooh.
Goldie Rogers in there right now after the attack from Paul Vachon. Beautiful body slam in there.
Oh, that could, that's an excessive headache.
Zika in there right now. Oh, what's going on? Goldie Rogers goes down.
Oh, guys. I need some Tylenol. Look at Lou Albano.
He was the ringside.
This was the former manager of Al Fonseca.
The former manager, Lou Albano, coming out at ringside. And the Samoans right now enraged over the presence of Albano at ringside. Here's the tag. Double whip. Oh, ring around the rosy. A little clothesline job in there by the Samoans. Oh. Could this be the backbreaker? Oh, sunset flip. Press, two, three. What a tremendous maneuver in there.
What power.
By the wild
what
Samoans.
Power. You know, I knew another Samoan that had a lot of power. God rest his soul, Peter Maivia.
Boy, you talk about a double-teaming combination working well together in that ring. That's the Wild Samoans.
They weren't born. They were chiseled.
Former champions of the World Wrestling Federation. Right now, let's get the official decision.
The winners of the match, the Wild Samoans.
Right now, let's pick up the action very quickly.
Oh,
what
look
a tremendous
at that.
Move in there, Angelo.
Great move.
Try for the press.
That's an athletic move, too.
The Samoans victorious in their bout. We'll be back with more exciting action on the World Wrestling Federation after this interview.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Montreal, Quebec, weighing 285 pounds, Paul Butcher Vachon. His opponent, now approaching the ring area, weighing 474 pounds, Andre the Giant.
Look at that sign, Andre the Giant. I'll tell you
what. It tells it all.
I hope the people at home have 25-inch TV sets, because did you see the back of Andre the Giant entering the ring?
Andre going against the Butcher, Paul Vachon, from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. There's the bell. The match officially underway.
If Butcher Vachon has any of the traits of his brother, Mad Dog, Andre could have his hands full here.
Paul Vachon right now, a little hesitant.
Oh, he's just stalking him.
Trying for a waist lock right now. A reverse waist lock. Look at Andre.
Oh.
Andre's got all the moves.
You see the girth on Andre the Giant.
7'4" tall.
Size 23 shoes. You know, my size 16s look small compared to those.
Vachon. Says Andre.
Uh-oh.
Huh?
Oh, no. Look at this.
Wait a minute. Hey, what's Kamala doing here?
What's Kamala doing here?
He's got no business interfering in this match. This is Andre's match.
That's
against
right.
Paul Vachon. He's got no business interfering
with
Andre.
But he wants a piece of Andre. And Friday, his man is trying to hold him back, Jack.
He has no business making an attempt to get into the ring against Andre.
This might have been a conspiracy with Paul Vachon.
The Giant Kamala, look at that. Trying to get up into that ring.
Friday is trying to hold him back. He's trying to restrain him.
Watch, but don't get in. Watch the match, but don't get in. That's what he's trying to tell him. As the match continues with Andre and Paul Vachon, the Butcher is down.
Andre's going to have to keep his eyes on that Kamala.
Well, he's not only got to watch
Kamala, he's got to watch the Butcher.
Oh, you're absolutely right, Jack.
The Butcher with a hard right hand. And a hard smash to the back of the neck. Another smash. Andre stunned somewhat by this turn of events. Paul Vachon.
Oh, did you see that
on the receiving end of that one. Andre.
I think Friday's got his man under control.
It's and like Andre, fighting two men, Angelo.
That's right.
Look at this takeoff. Oh. Backdrop by Andre the Giant.
Andre's got everything under control now. Oh, you see that size 23 come down across the head.
Look at him looking over at Kamala. Andre watching Vachon on one side, watching Kamala on the other side. It's like fighting two men.
Andre's given Kamala the signal by patting his stomach.
Friday trying to get Kamala out. He doesn't want a suspension to his man.
No.
That's why he wants to get him out of there. All right, Andre now continuing with Paul Vachon.
Oh, all 475 pounds. You know, he's 7'2", and with that hair, he might look like about 7'6".
Paul Vachon right now really feeling the effects of this tremendous Andre the Giant.
Uh-oh. And Paul Vachon is no small man. Look at the comparison there, Jack. Look at that comparison.
Andre right now going to whip him into the ring ropes. Look at this. Down goes Vachon.
Good night.
Six. Try for a press. Two, three. That's it.
It's all over but the shout.
What a tremendous victory by Andre the Giant against the Butcher, Paul Vachon. Oh, the fans love Andre.
A great
they love Andre
by
the
a
Giant.
Great person.
Let's go up to the ring right now and get the official decision.
The winner of the match, Andre the Giant.
There's your winner, Andre the Giant. Angelo, next week, I want to remind all of our fans out there watching the greatest stars in the world of professional wrestling. Iron Mike Sharp, who claims to be Canada's best, will take on the young man from England, the Dynamite Kid.
That should be a great match.
The World Wrestling Federation bringing you all of the great superstars of the world of professional wrestling. And there goes truly one great star right now, victorious in his bout, Paul Vachon. All right, let's pick up the action once again. Andre the Giant, watch the boot.
Oh,
he caught him right under the jaw.
Good night, it's all over. Jack, I'm
Andre
gonna say
the
one
Giant.
Thing.
Come on down, Andre. That's it.
That's
unbelievable.
That's a great victory, and it's great been working with you, Jack.
The World Wrestling Federation with this special interview right now. Stand by for more.